Storyboard, Zenith Optimedia reveals a few key mobile marketing trends to watch out for. HDFC Bank is making the consumer hum a new tune as the bank launches a musical logo as a part of their sonic branding initiative. Maruti Suzuki's new campaign urges the consumer to take a leap. Hello and welcome to Storyboard. This is Shivani Gharat. While every marketer is talking about the increase in the internet usage on mobile phones in India, we are still battling with the basics, such as call drops. India has one of the highest penetration of smartphones, hence no marketer can dare ignore this medium despite poor connectivity. Zenith Optimedia's digital outfit Performix and Resultrix has released a report on the global mobile ecosystem that suggests India is reaching a mobile tipping point. We have Storyboard editor Anant Rangaswamy in conversation with Anupriya Acharya, Group CEO Zenith Optimedia, and Tanmay Mohanty, Managing Director of Performix and Resultrix. Let's hear the conversation.
Anupriya, to begin with, can you share with us the three or four trends that you see relevant to India from the study that they wrote?
Yeah, so I'll just give a little background on the study first. So there's a study that we do, and this we've done with Global Web Index with a sample size of 200,000 globally. And some of the emerging trends which we find relevant for India as well, clearly we find that more and more usage has started happening on mobile. We've also, clearly the usage is very different for the younger audiences as compared to the older audiences. And the core heavy users of mobile obviously are lying between 16 to 24 years of age. What we are seeing, which is very interesting, is that the access of the web, of the net, on the mobile in these users is the highest on mobile as compared to all the other devices combined. And that we are calling it as the mobile tipping point. So we find that some of the markets have already reached that tipping point. More importantly for India, we're talking about India as a market. India is set to reach that in 2017, which means that by 2017, the maximum access of web will be from mobile as compared to all the other devices combined.
Right.
So that obviously has implication for the marketers.
Sure.
Now, this is also, showing that there is a clear change in behavior in the consumers as well. One of the key ones, of course, is search. So, more and more search for people who are using mobile is moving from the web browser to the applications, because that is primarily how people use mobiles.
Right.
So, we find a clear drop on that, about almost 6% points in only 4 quarters' time. And obviously, as it accelerates, it clearly shows that marketers will have to obviously modify their search models as well. The second thing that is coming out from there clearly is the ad blocking behavior, which is on the rise. So online privacy, we have heard a lot, in the Western countries for some time, but increasingly it is coming out as a trend in India as well. And more people are wary about, whether their family is knowing that what they are browsing, or whether the marketer knows what they are browsing, and there's clear avoidance on that. So either they are ensuring that they don't let the cookies land, or they are ensuring that they use private browsing mechanisms. So clearly it's indicating that. And this again has very clear implication for the marketers, because the first thing which it will do is impact this whole model of banner advertising, especially on mobiles, which actually should have gone out by now altogether. But whatever remaining form of mobile banners is there, this is also going to decline very, very fast, because that's the first thing which is going to be killed because of this whole movement towards online privacy. And the other thing then, hence on mobile, as internet browsing increases on mobile, the native advertising, which is the in-stream advertising, is something which is clearly going to rise a lot.
Right.
Already we see a lot of success with the varieties of Facebook, for example. So that's clearly another trend which is coming up.
Right. Now, before I come to you, Tanmay, we're living in an India where in metro India you can't get a signal, let alone get 4G and 3G.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't even get a signal.
Yeah.
And all your study is predicated on some universal perfect bandwidth. You're talking 4G now, I don't know.
Yeah.
there's no 3G, there's no 2G. So, what is the use of this study if nobody gets a signal?
So this study, of course, is based on actual usage, how people are consuming it actually. So obviously, it takes into account whether they had all this difficulty in accessing the web, whether they accessed it on EE or 2G or 3G. 4G is yet to come, so that is right. The one of the key challenges, of course, in India continues to be the infrastructure. But I mean, it is set to improve over the next few years.
We heard that a few years ago.
That's right. Mm. We've been hearing it for some time actually, right. And we've been hearing about 4G launching also for some time, but it has launched eventually. But we believe that movement is going to happen. As I said, this study is not based on questionnaire. It is based on actual usage. So it takes into account all the grievances which these people might use.
So, Tanmay, just to make it clear to our viewers, what was the study like? Can you tell us precisely what the study was?
The study was a consent-driven device track reporting for the customer. So WebIndex basically takes into consideration the consent of the user to drop a tracking module inside the beacon inside the device and track the customer's behavior.
Right.
For a certain period of time. And this takes into 200,000 plus customer worldwide and almost 10% of it coming from India at any given time.
Right. Anupriya, you know, your study says that one of the challenges of the future, once we cross this tipping point, is going to be the content available in vernacular.
Yeah.
So again, it's not your business, but where is the infrastructure, the ecosystem which will deliver content in the vernacular? If that is so key to communicating with consumers.
It is very much our business actually. So see, on that, Anand, we've clearly seen that across all media, whether it was television, whether it is radio, whether it is print, vernacular is clearly driving the growth, and digital is no different because eventually it's only a different platform. The fact is that vernacular is something people are comfortable with, their own language people are comfortable in. So on that, all the stakeholders of this will need to show movement. So we find that there is enough initiative from whether it is the publishers on the digital content. So all your key publishers like the key leading newsprint providers like Dainik Jagran and Dainik Bhaskar, all of them have started making movement and they have large teams which are putting up vernacular content on the net. Similarly, we find on videos, user-based content, there is a huge, explosion in terms of vernacular content available. Google and Facebook clearly are also taking steps in that direction. So it is right, vernacular will accelerate this movement only further. How soon are we able to create a whole infrastructure around it is something that we'll have to see.
Right. When I look at the study, it looks like the tipping point in something magical will happen. So try and simplify it. What is going to happen? What is going to change from today till to the date of this tipping point? What will happen?
Yeah, it's not it's not magical as much as it is important to know and acknowledge that what we call as okay, mobile is happening and it is going to change consumer behavior and all of that. It is more to acknowledge that this time is not very far away. And the fact that majority of the 16 to 24 year olds in India by 2017 will be accessing the web on mobile has a clear implication on the behavior, because the behavior on mobile is very different from a browser based when you are accessing it from a desktop or a laptop. And that behavior, if that changes, clearly the marketers also need to take cognizance.
So what are the things that marketer needs to do? The three, four things that marketer needs to do now with this?
So for example, is their content mobile ready? We talked about search, which is moving on to, a lot of it is now moving on to the applications. Are they ready with that aspect? Content, for example, a lot of videos currently on the net we find are vertical videos. Okay, which is basically recorded in a vertical format, which is on a mobile, it's a very good experience. Okay, so are we moving to that? So all these things, so the marketers essentially will need to take cognizance of this fact, one, and two is right now a lot of creation of whether it is content, whether it is messaging, it is all towards a maybe a desktop first or a laptop first kind of a behavior,
right,
which is set to change.
Right.
And mobile is still we find in a lot of cases more as an afterthought. And so, you know, if we want, then that browser will be made.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you, Padmani. Thank you.
It is time for us to take a short break. When we return, we find out how HDFC Bank is creating a new way to communicate with the consumers.